Well, here they are, the finalists for the new flag that will fly across Minnesota. That was supposed to be the top five, was amended tonight at a special meeting to now make it six. That the public will get a chance to weigh in on. And now, of course, it's crunch time.
The State Emblems Redesign Commission has to pick just one by January 1st. Jennifer Hoff details the big job they have ahead of them.
In the halls of Minnesota's Senate building, that's the sound of history being made.
Oh, yeah.
Even if it takes some time.
We all knew going into this, like, we have a tight deadline here. I'm not sure if we're going to have time for tweaks.
Anita Talsman-Gall and a dozen others picked to vote on the state's new flag design.
It has that mirroring image.
Met for the first time in person, tasked with sticking up for their favorites.
It's so simple and just kind of eye-catching.
To narrow down more than 2,200 public submissions to now just six.
It's very 2023. It looks beautiful. I love it.
Deep discussions followed about what will be a dramatic shift in imagery that hasn't really changed in more than 100 years, that some say is offensive to Native Americans and lacks basic design principles. The legislature creating the commission and signing this new step into law last spring.
That's the beauty, I think, of having all these different voices here. Yes, it draws out the conversation. We have to think through this every way, front, forward, backwards, and reverse.
They favor just a few colors and the North Star, simple symbols that still carry a lot of meaning across the whole state.
We see the rivers as the veins of Mother Earth, and there's some real beauty there.
Rallying through several rounds to figure out a flag finalist.
That's a powerful symbol.
Yeah.
In hopes it stands the test of time.
I get to be part of history.
Pretty cool. The commission now can settle on that one design, but then they can actually still continue to tweak it. Their job also includes finalizing a new state seal as well, from about 400 submissions of those. The new flag will fly on May 11th, which is Statehood Day here, unless the legislature vetoes it. Then I don't know, I guess they got to go through this whole process.
I hope they don't have to start over.
But I have to say, the last time when we reported on this, it was kind of funny. We poked fun at some of the designs.
Oh, there were so many funny submissions.
This time around, the weight of what they were deciding and how serious this is could just really be felt in that meeting.
Sure. And so subjective. I mean, on social media tonight, I hope the commission maybe isn't looking at comments.
You can't satisfy everybody.
Exactly. No. All right, thanks, Jennifer. Mm-hmm.